Greetings to all. Today, we are going to discuss about a booming technology in today's world, that is IoT, Internet of Things. So what is Internet of Things? Internet of Things is a system of interrelated computing devices, mechanical, digital machines, objects, animals, or people that are provided with some unique identifiers and ability to transfer data over the network without requiring any human-to-human or human-to-computer interactions. In simple words, Internet of Things is an extension of internet connectivity into the physical devices and everyday objects embedded with some electronics, internet connectivity, and other forms of hardware. These devices can be communicate and interact with each other over the internet. Even they can be remotely monitored and controlled. Friends, here we have some definitions from different sources. Gartner says, IoT is the network of physical objects that contains embedded technology to communicate and sense or interact with their internal states or external environment. Whereas in Wikipedia, we find IoT's definition such as IoT is a network of physical devices which buildings and other items embedded with some electronics, software, sensors, actuators, and network connectivity that enables this object to collect and exchange the data. Whereas Digital Trends defines IoT in the term of like everyday device equipped with some sensors and the connectivity to work together, understand what we are doing and operate automatically to make our lives easier. So here are some definitions for Internet of Things. So in short, we can say IoT is the network of physical objects that contains embedded technology to sense and interact with their environment and each other to collect exchange data to make our lives better. Now we'll understand how Internet of Things becomes so popular. First, we'll see how internet is connected with the people, and then after we'll see how the things are connected with the things over the internet. As we all know, we use internet connection for communication, for data transfer, as well as for some applications use. So this is a simple use that machine and people can come together over the internet. But how things are connected with the things on internet? So moving to that point, first we'll see different evolution happen in the industries. There are, we can say, mainly five evolution happen in technical terms in the industries, like pre-internet, after internet, some services into internet, then how people connected with the internet, and the Internet of Things. We'll go stepwise. In 1968, first PLC was introduced. PLC means Programmable Logic Controller. PLC is an industrial computer that automates various electromechanical processes and makes a logical-based decision. So we can say that M2M, that is machine-to-machine communication, started. These devices are conceptualized. So that time, human-to-human communication happened with a wire connectivity, such as fixed or mobile telephony or the SMS. After that, in 1983, standardization of Ethernet comes into the picture. Ethernet is a technology that connects different network topologies, such as local area network, metropolitan area network, and worldwide area network. So all these networking topologies connected with the internet. In the year of 1989, invention of World Wide Web, that is internet, happened, which makes us easier to share and research information over the net. So we can say here, this era where we communicate through email, we get and upload information on internet, even you use internet for entertainment. After that, with the help of internet, we move into the e-commerce side, where with the help of IT platforms and the services, we use internet connections for different services. After, in 1995, Microsoft introduced Windows to the world, which gives us a new type of operating systems, which is compatible, plug and play, and even easy to use. While we move forward, then with the help of internet, we start using social medias to communicate with the people, such as Skype, Facebook, YouTube. So here, we were communicating over the internet, but only people were communicating with the other people over the internet. After that, smart devices comes, such as smartphones, smart objects, etc., which help us to interact devices with other devices over the internet. We can say machine-to-machine communication, such as identification, tracking, monitoring, metering, automation, actuation, payment, etc. So this all comes under the Internet of Things. So when this Internet of Things is introduced to the world, so guys, in 1999, the world first introduced with IoT and its technologies, which help us to develop various sectors and the industries. So these are some evolution happen in technological industries. So based on that, now we can predict the future of IoT. See, till now, if you look over this image, you can say that from 2008, total devices, 2008 in IoT comes into the picture, whereas till 2013, near to 11.2 billion IoT devices were connected over the net. And we can expect that till 2020, till 50 billion devices can be connected. So obviously, it's a booming technology, we can say, in nowadays. But the guys, question comes here, why is the IoT is booming happening now? There should be some reason for this. So we'll just look into the reasons. IoT devices are growing at the explosive rate, at we as know that there are already 44 billion IoT devices in the world. IoT has been the great potential to change almost all the businesses and the domains and life spheres. IoT solutions can provide companies with the plenty of benefits, such as we can say increased workflow efficiency, revolution in the healthcare, new learning environments, innovative tech approaches, significant reduction in number of accidents, or heating and the lightning controls. So all these benefits we can get under the IoT. And why it's happening? Obviously, availability of networking. If we can see, here we have a proper Wi-Fi LTE connections available to every place in the world. So by 2018 or 19, half of the world is connected with the internet. Then comes with the affordability. For example, one sensor cost in the IoT dropped every more down. By the end of the decade, the price of the sensors will be almost near to $0.30. So we can say now, electronics, embedded electronics are affordable as well. Even though the scalability, many devices offer simply plug and play functionality. Nowadays, we have different operating systems which will be working for us easily. You might heard about ML, machine learning, AI. So many new technologies are there which can be help in IoT to get the booming sector. As I explained you, average sensor cost, if you see, from 2004 till 2020 is almost decreasing through 7.5 till 0.12, whereas estimate penetration of global population is increasing, like internet usage. If we see from 2005 till 2019, we have increased with the internet connectivity. So all these points are, we can say, are the reason for this booming IoT technologies. Now friends, we'll see some IoT worlds today. So here we'll see what are the possible IoT prototypes we have. Before moving to all this example, I would like to explain something about today's IoT prototypes. See, all this today's world IoT are connected with the decision makers and the implementers, including those in C-suites, IT's, line of business and the managers on a single platform. So why they can use IoT technology and its infrastructure for the vertical group? This new wave of IoT connectivity is going to be beyond the laptop and the smartphone connectivity. It's going towards the connected cars, smart homes, connected wearables, smart cities, connected healthcare, basically connected life. It increases and improves the quality of productivity of life, society as well as some industries. So we'll see some of today's IoT prototypes we have. You can see here, we can use IoT technology in oil and gas industry. Here we have even one example. You can see through that gas pipeline, if the pressure or the temperature changes, then the calibration will tell us there is some mistake with the pressure and the temperature, and simultaneously all the data can be communicated in the real time, so that all this can be controlled before any disaster happens. Even we can keep track of any employee safety, we can optimize the routes, even we can optimize the forecast future volumes as well. Second example of today's IoT prototype we have is as smart pill bottles. So this prototype contains with a hub that we can connect on the wall. This is connected with the internet, and cap transmit the data to hub. So it always reminds us whether we have took the medicine or not, whether we have missed it. If the refill time is come, then refill button automatically connects all the data with the pharmacy via the phone, and it's very cheap as well. So with the help of these smart pill bottles, we can monitor our medications. The next example of today's IoT prototype we have is smart contact lens. So what is smart contact lens can be? Obviously, it's an IoT device, which is one of the most anticipated medical IoT technology. The smart contact lens will look like a regular contact lens, but it becomes with a sensor that it can track the blood sugar level of the user non-invasively through their tears and correct vision in the new innovative way. So guys, we can use this for the medical purpose, so we can keep a track of our blood sugar. Even IoT can be helpful in some disaster relief. We can't say that disaster, whatever disaster is happening, can be reduced through IoT. We can't say so that. But due to high population density and the poor evacuation infrastructure and exposure to the severe weather events, developing countries has disappointingly exposed to their risk of natural disaster and often have limited means for their effects. So as consequences, according to the World Bank study, more than 90% of all the deaths caused due to disaster occur in developing countries. So here IoT comes into the picture. IoT technology can't stop the disaster from happening, but yes, definitely it can be very useful for disaster preparedness, such as prediction and early warning system. In this way, IoT can compensate for the poor infrastructure that put developing and emerging countries into the vulnerable position. So, whenever we want a disaster relief, it can help us in such a ways like remote control functions that alerts vending machines to dispense drinks and during the disaster freely. Even it will show us the current locations. Like, for example, stickers are on the all vending machines in the Japan to track location immediately. Some electronic display raise awareness for public announcement. Even the storage battery allows machines to operate during the power storage. So these are some IoT benefits we can get in the during the time of disaster relief. So we can see here, in the normal day, we can have different applications of IoT in our lives, such as smart variables, smart home automation. We can have drone, okay, my car. If I'll give you best example, suppose a person is wearing a smart band. So whatever his sleep timing will be regulate accordingly. It can put an alarm as well. So at particular time, he will get the wake up alarm. Before he wake up from the bed, automatically whatever delivery has delivery of the food supply, it will provide with the drone. Even IoT can keep a track of his vehicle, as well as IoT can control his lighting of the home, temperature, that is AC, as well as some kitchen functions. So see, IoT is very useful in normal day actions as well. You just have to think about it, where we can use IoT, and obviously it can be available. But we have seen now, like, what are the benefits of IoT, what are examples in daily life. Even we have seen different evolution happen in the industries, but how all this evolution happen? Just see, first people were connecting with the things. For example, a person wearing a smart band or smart watch will keep track of his motions, will keep track of his heartbeat, and will communicate over the internet to the hospital or to the medical report. And he can have a health tracker for his exercise. So this is a simple way that people are connecting with the things. And that smart watch, that is my smart band, can be communicate or automate my smart home. I can keep track of my vehicle on my watch. Even I can keep a track of my city's traffic. If you can have a accessibility of your office admin, you can have automation of your office also, as well as you can do some online shopping, retailing, and you can keep a track of your medical health. So all this can be happen with the thing that people is connected with. Now we'll see how things are connecting with the things. As we have seen before, how people are connected with the things. Now we'll turn to see how the things are connected with other things. IoT also sometimes referred to as an internet of everything that consists of all the web-enabled devices that collect, send, and act on the data that they are acquired from their surroundings, environment, using embedded sensors, processors, communication hardware, etc. All these devices often called as connected or the smart devices. This is also called as M2M communication, that is machine-to-machine communication, and act on the same. They get information from one other, or in the same way, the things can connected with the things in the IoT. Now you can see here, some smart devices and the sensors are connected with the internet, that means on the cloud, with the help of the gateway. So while the things are connecting with the things, they can communicate, transfer the data to each other over the internet, and can have automation and the control for each thing. For example, we can use our smartphone to communicate information to control my transportation. I can use my smartphone as camera. I can use smartphone as a remote for my washing machine at the home. Same times, I can use a keep track of my office cameras. So you can see in IoT, we can have many access and the application to things connected with each other. Now we'll see some potentials of IoT which will help us to increase quality and the effectivity of industries. Despite its rising importance in the tech market, the full potential of IoT hasn't yet to be unleashed. In the next few years, we'll see an explosion of IoT products and application not only for the retail markets but also in the manufacturing, health and the transportations, some security sector as well, because obviously IoT is a leading to more efficient processes. It gives us a major industries the data that they need. It uncovers new economical potentials. It also reduces cost and the waste. It boosting productivity and efficiency. So we can say, with the help of this IoT potential, we can have smart cities or the regions, smart cars, mobility, that means we are talking about smart transportation, smart home and assisted living, smart industries, public safety, energy and environmental protection, agriculture as well as in tourism. So with the help of IoT, we can make very positive changes into all these things. Now we'll see some applications of IoT, such as smart homes, wearables, smart cities, smart grid, industrial internet, connected car. So many things are there. We'll just move further with the smart home. So when we say intelligent home, that means we are talking about home automation. Home automation means you are automating each of every process at your home with the help of smart machine, such as smart egg tray. When we say smart egg tray, that means it will give me the stock of eggs that I have in my egg. Smart washing machine. Smart washing machine means I can remotely access my washing machine with the help of IoT. Smart lighting. Smart AC. Smart AC, that means I can control temperature of my room from anywhere in the world with the help of my smartphone. Smart sleep system, which will keep track when I can wake up, when I fall asleep. Smart weather station. It will intimate me what is the weather station. It will intimate me what will be the weather of my city before I am moving out of the house. Some smart slow cookers, smart garbage cans. Garbage cans, we can say smart because whenever it will fill, it will intimate me, setting that to take the decisions can be made. Smart gardening. Okay, so these all examples were about related to home automation. When it comes to the transportation, we can use IoT in transportation as well. So as we discuss, IoT has many applications in the many sectors, but when we can say transportation, that means we are talking about every aspect of transportation, such as suppose at every layer of transportation, IoT provides improved communication control and data distribution. This application includes personal vehicles, commercial vehicles, trains, UAVs and other equipments. We can say it can extend throughout the entire system all of the transportation elements, such as traffic control, parking, fuel consumption and many more. here we can see that all the vehicles are connected with each other and collecting the data, and it is sharing their locations, vehicle metrics, driver behaviors, and hours and miles driven to the owner. And this can be stored at the cloud and can have an application over it. Now we'll see some use cases of IoT. There are many cases that we can study on IoT, but here I have selected some for you. Some IoT based pest control. It will keep a control of pest in my farming, optimizing the power grid, growing better grapes for the better vino, saving bees. These are some real-time IoT applications that we have in the market, such as smart home, connected cars, smart vehicle, smart grid, smart farming, smart cities. These all are really innovative IoT uses that we can have in today's life. Now moving further, we'll see some IoT components. So before understanding which are the IoT components we have in Internet of Things, first we'll discuss what does exactly things in the Internet of Things. So when we say things, that means we are talking about the physical things, as we have seen in the definition. We can say the things in the Internet of Things are embedded computing devices or embedded systems that transmit and receive information over the network for the purpose of controlling another devices or interacting with users. A thing is also can be a microcontroller or the microprocessor based device, such as namely we can say RFID tags or MAC addresses, which we use for identification and the info storage. Some sensor networks which you use for sensors, values and information collection. Some commands and data for processing information. Transmitting and receiving messages for communication. And obviously, lastly but not least, the one that is switch and the motors to control actuations. So these are the things that we are talking about whenever we are talking Internet of Things. Now we'll see some building blocks of IoT. Basically, there are four blocks for IoT. First is sensor, second one is the processors, third one is gateway, and the fourth one is application. If you can see here, when we say sensors, that means we are talking about device layer. When we say processors, that means we are talking about communication and servicing. Then comes with the gateway, management, security, and then lastly the applications. Each of these nodes has to have their own characteristics in order to form the useful IoT systems. Now we'll see architecture of IoT. So there are four stages in the architecture of IoT. In stage 1, an IoT architecture consists of network things, typically wireless sensors and the actuators, that means physical devices such as your smartphone, your Raspberry Pi, your car, your Wi-Fi connection, some controller like Arduino, and devices that use for home automation. Second stage comes with the includes of sensors data aggregation system and analog to digital data conversion, where exactly analog to digital data conversion happens. The third stage is IT system platform, which used to pre-processing the data before it moves on the data center to the cloud with the help of some communication protocols such as MQTT or HTTP. Then finally comes stage 4. In stage 4, the data is analyzed, managed and stored on a traditional backend data center systems. So you can see here event processing and analytics. So here exactly the data analysis happened. So basically in IoT architecture, we have four layers. This example, this pictorial presentation will show us exactly how four stages works. See, in the stage 1, we have some sensors actuated, whether they are wired or wireless. This can communicate with the stage 2, the sensors actuators data acquisition. So, whatever data captured by these sensors are to be processed here. Under the stage 3, HIT, which is called as HIT, actually data composition and analytics happen. We can say it's a pre-processing data before we send it to the cloud. And the last stage we have, that is data center and the clouds, where exactly your IoT application lies. So when we say first to second stage, that means we are analytically management controlling. When we say stage 2 to 3, that means we are talking about analytics management control. When stage 3 to 4, that means we are talking about analytics management control. So these are some 4 layers we have in architecture of IoT. Now we'll see some technologies which are used in IoTs. So basically, whenever we are talking about Internet of Things, that means we are talking about some things. We should have some devices with us. Those are called as hardware. Now these devices should communicate over the internet. So we should have communication technology also. After that, to communicate data through these devices, we have some protocols which we can use for communication. And after that, to analyze and manage the data, we have some IDEs and softwares. And last, we have some cloud platforms where exactly our application of IoT lies. So here we have some commonly used IoT sensors. You may are aware about all these sensors, but some sensors are very useful in home automation. Suppose, for example, I want to do a IoT prototype for home automation. So which sensors I can use? I can use a temperature sensors, some pressure sensors, water quality sensors. I can use chemical sensor, gas sensor, smoke sensor. I can use image sensor, some motion detection sensor, and humidity sensors. So see, here we have number of sensors with the help of which we can do vast number of IoT applications. These are some smart boards we can use in IoT. For example, we have Arduino, we have Raspberry Pi, we have Galileo. So basically, this controller get the data from sensor and upload it to the network. And meanwhile, the help of some APIs and the softwares will calibrate this sensor and will do the automation. So these are very very basic controller board that we have in Internet of Things. Sensors and actuators. So as we say, our first layer is a device layer. So where actual sensors and actuator physical devices lies, we see some IoT technologies such as communication technology. As we have discussed before, these all embedded devices communicate over the internet. So obviously, we need some communication technology. Communication technology plays an important role in any wireless network. The network comprises on energy consistent devices required, low power technologies. IoT is a new and processing concept that provides connectivity over internet via smart sensing devices to attain identification and the management in heterogeneous connectivity environment. Various communication technologies for wireless personal area network like IoT available, presenting several opportunities in IoT concepts, involves all the heterogeneous objects around us communicating with each other locally and globally via internet. So here we have some protocols that we use to communicate and transfer the data over the internet. We can have COAP, that's Contract Application Protocol, MQTT to send the message. These all are related to the networking protocol, with the help of which we can transfer the data. Device can communicate with each other. Then in new component we have is cloud. Cloud means we are talking about internet storage, where our applications lies. So after all these things, we'll now see what are the different challenges we have in IoT. As we all know, the biggest challenge that we have in Internet of Things is the connectivity of the devices. To connect a devices, we should have better internet connectivity and the networks. Then power management. As all these devices are wireless or wired one, it should always have power connection with them. So whenever we are talking about automation or any IoT application, that time we have to take care of power management as well. Then security comes. Security of the data that we are uploading and communicating over the devices. As this security is very essential, because the data can be related to your health or your personal information. And the rapid evolution happens in IoT sector. Every time, every day, some new exciting technology coming in IoT. So obviously, IoT should have all the updated technology with us, such as, for example, augmented reality we can have. We can have virtual reality with the IoT. Everything we can have with the IoT. Okay, here we have finished our first session for introduction of Internet of Things. I hope you enjoyed and learned too many things today. Thank you.